Today, we'll be showing you how to use Visualization Project Diagnostics. Project Diagnostics is a great tool for detecting errors and potential problems in a visualization project before running it at the end user site. This reduces the time needed for putting the system into operation. What is more, unused objects can be removed from the visualization project once it is completed. Project Diagnostics is included in both versions of the Reliance Design Development Environment, Desktop and Enterprise. Some visualization systems do not have such a tool at all, or you have to pay for it. In the Reliance SCADA system, it is a standard part of the development environment with no additional charge. Project Diagnostics is designed to check all or just some parts of the project. After its completion, a list of potential errors, problems, and warnings is displayed. To solve an issue, invoke the corresponding manager or dialog box by double-clicking on the issue line. As you already know, the diagnostics allows finding objects, tags for example, that have been defined within the project, but are not used. Issues can be caused, for example, by entering incomplete property values, by deleting objects such as tags to which other objects are linked, by renaming tags used in scripts, or by not translating a text string used in a multi-language project. Before asking for technical support regarding an issue in your visualization project, perform project diagnostics first and fix all issues. Once you do that, test whether everything works correctly. Project Diagnostics is a very handy and quick tool. In today's example, we want to show you how to perform project diagnostics, display the list of all issues, and fix them. First, we'll open a simple project in Reliance Design. This project will allow us to see how to use the diagnostics. After that, we'll set up and perform the diagnostics in the Project Diagnostics Wizard. Finally, we will display and immediately solve the detected issues. So, let's get started. We must first run the Reliance Design Development Environment and open the project. Now, let's open the Device Manager, add a device of type Modbus, and define a float type tag in this device. We can name it Temperature 1. Then, the device must be connected to the computer. We can now add a display component to the visualization window without linking it to the tag. This can easily happen to you if you are, for example, disturbed at work by people talking loudly or by phone calls. How can we detect such an error? From the project menu, choose the Perform Diagnostics command to open the Project Diagnostics wizard. The first step of the wizard allows you to choose which issues should be detected. The second step contains a list of project scopes to scan. Let's click on the Perform button to run the diagnostics. Upon completion, the number of detected issues is shown. We can now display the diagnostics results window with a detailed list of issues. As you can see, there is the issue we know about. Check out how to fix it. Double-click on the issue line to open the property editor. The cursor is positioned exactly where we need it. We can now link the display to the tag and check whether the problem has been solved. We can see that the issue has been fixed and disappeared from the list. Next, let's take a look at another type of issue revealed by Project Diagnostics, which is an unintentional deletion of the tag to which our display is linked. Let's go back to the Device Manager and delete the tag. Then, perform the diagnostics again. Here we go. This is the issue. There's also another problem that says there's no tag defined within the Modbus device. We will now get rid of the problems. First, let's fix the missing tag. Double-click on the issue line to open the device manager and create the tag. Now we can perform the diagnostics again. As you can see, there is only one issue remaining. There is no link between the display and the tag. Again, we must double-click to open the display's property editor and specify the link to the tag. Now let's check whether everything is okay. Project Diagnostics also allows you to detect unused objects, and another useful tool that you can use is finding object usages. First, in the Device Manager, we can add another two tags, Temperature 2 and 3, that will not be used in the project. After that, we need to perform the diagnostics again. In Step 1, the Unused Objects option must be activated. We can see here that the two new tags are not used anywhere. Therefore, they can be selected and deleted. The gray color indicates that the unused tags have been deleted. We can open the Device Manager to make sure they're gone. The last feature we want to show you in today's video is finding object usages. For example, you want to know where a tag is used. Let's go to the Device Manager, select our tag, right-click to open the pop-up menu, and choose the Find Object Usages command. This opens the Find Object Usages wizard, where we can choose project scopes to be scanned to find usages of the tag. We are going to scan the entire project. As you can see, there's only one occurrence of the tag. To be exact, the tag is used in Display 1, Window 1. Double-clicking on the line in the Object Usage Search Results window will get us to the place where the tag is linked. Of course, objects in your project, tags for example, will be used in more places, such as alarms, trends, scripts, or reports. Lastly, let me show you a project with multiple issues. This project has been prepared to show you various types of issues that can be revealed by the diagnostics. As you can see, 44 issues have been detected. They could be fixed in the same way as we have just shown you. So, what do you think? Project Diagnostics is pretty handy, isn't it? If you come across a problem in your project, do not forget to perform the diagnostics first and fix potential errors. If the problem persists, then you should contact our support team.